Hi, this is Rick Eimer with the Palo Alto Weekly, and we're here today with Grace King, a Menlo School athlete, volleyball player, who this last weekend participated in the Spike Fest tournament. They went 3-2, and Grace was one of the leading players on the team that finished second in their division and sixth overall, and that's a 32-team tournament, which is pretty darn good. They only lost a couple of teams that were CCS champions last year, so it's not too shabby. And so, Grace, let's just kind of start by talking about the Spike Fest and how you guys did.
Yeah, we definitely had a strong start. Our first two games were started off, I guess, like easier than the later ones would be. But to get out of our division, to go into playoffs, we played St. Francis, who we had played like just 2 days earlier. And we put up a fight with them, but it didn't end up going our way. And then we beat Presentation in the first round of playoffs. We were in the silver division. And then we ended up losing to Midi, but it was also it was a really close game.
Yeah, all three of those teams are very good teams, by the way, so it's not like they were playing nobodies. So, and of course, you're not the only one on the team, but, you do kind of, I guess they count on you to do all the killing and things like that. You know, I hate to put it that it sounds odd, but kind of just talk about the dynamics of a team. You have two setters, and so how do you work with them, and how does that go?
Yeah, so we do have two new setters this year. They're both freshmen, Hannah Hoffman and Zoe Gregory, and they have definitely stepped up to the plate this so far this season. And being a freshman, just like that, can be a very stressful situation for them, especially when there's like crowds and stuff. But they've definitely done a really good job, and I think our team has begun to get a lot more comfortable with each other recently after having played together for the last month or so. But yeah, definitely new, very different from last year, but it'll get better, I think. Yeah.
Yeah. This is a team that won a state title 2 years ago. And there's still some people left from it. I know there's been a lot of graduations, and I want to talk about that a little bit. You have the sister Siana, who is the sister of one of the girls that won the state title with you guys, and you and her also seem to be a really good back row pair. And, I know that sometimes there's back row specialists, but with you, you play on the court all the time. How do you switch mindsets, or does that even have anything to do?
Definitely, Siana's been a big, I've never been that much of a back row player until more this past year. But Siana's been definitely someone I have turn to on the court. She's always super positive, and she's so helpful when with just technique stuff, and she's also one of my best friends and just off the court. So it's been so fun the last 3 years playing with her. Yeah, this year especially, it's really fun.
Yeah, and I know that sometimes obviously a kill gets the crowd going, because it's a big point, but on a nice dig, can get the crowd going too, because you saved a point.
Yeah.
So, do you have any better reaction to a kill yourself personally or to a dig?
I think that there's certain kills, I guess, you get, or someone on your team gets, where, they look really good, and so everyone will just go crazy. But there's also, it's the exact same for digs. Someone can get crazy up, and I've seen, a lot of girls on our team have already shown that. Siana's always getting the craziest digs, and Riley Holland, our libero, she's also just been super good and consistent this season. But I don't know, for me, seeing just anyone do anything that's looking good or helping the team is just really cool.
Good motivation.
Yeah.
The other thing too is serving. I know you've served up a few aces in your day. How serious do you guys take that? Obviously, you take it sort of serious, but is that something you have to work on all the time?
Yeah, we do work on serving a lot. Our coach actually just told us that the importance of serving aggressive. So even if we're making errors, as long as we're keeping up with making a lot of aces, like with an error every once in a while, then it's okay. So I think that our team has focused a lot on serving because our head coach Marco always tells us that like that's the one part of the game like you can control, because that's the one time when the ball's in your hand and yeah, like you just have all the control. You're not really relying on anyone else. So I think we do, our team does take a big, yeah, we focus on that a lot.
Yeah. Now, do you guys talk about goals at all? I mean, do you say, hey, we want to get back to state, or do you just say we just want to be better than we were, or how does that go?
Yeah, I think the goal is always to get back to state, especially because there's four of us on the team who were part of the team that won states. So I think that we're especially always thinking about that, and the younger players, like them knowing that like we got there, I think they really want it too. And obviously our coach. And so I think that's always the main goal. And then just like winning the big important games and focusing on league games. I think those are all our goals, and just, yeah, continuing to improve.
And I might add that Menlo is also in a pretty tough league. It's, you know, it may not be the WCAL, but the WBAL is still a really, really good volleyball league. The Notre Dame Belmont's in it, who's been to the state championships. And,
yeah,
of course, Sacred Heart Prep was there last year. So it's, you know, when you go to league, I mean, is that, you feel like you're ready because of your preseason schedule?
I think, yeah, we've definitely been given. I think we've been given a pretty tough preseason schedule. Our first three games were... gave us a good challenge, and I think that it'll definitely prepare us for league, which will be, I think, more competitive this year than it was last year. But I think it'll be good for us, and I think we'll be ready when the time comes. Yeah.
Okay, great. So we've been talking to Grace King. She's our Girls Athlete of the Week this week, and congratulations.
Thank you.
And if you want to find out about next week's Athlete of the Week, just click that button down below, subscribe button, or visit us online at pasportsonline.com.